What's up, kids? Solid Mike, back with another video. Welcome to my office. If that's not the greatest sound you've ever heard, I don't know what is. Shout out to Spike. They don't sponsor me, but I like to feed good products to you guys. And I think Spike's the best energy drink on the market, hands down. No questions asked. Best taste, best feeling, best value. To the young gentleman in the last video that said, hey, maybe if you stop talking about your beanie and the weather before the video, you'd get more views. And to you, my sir, I say, this probably isn't the place for you. If you want to go listen to some boring science guy read off of a script or a PowerPoint and get fed lines all day, this ain't the spot for you. If you want to learn some applicable knowledge, you want to have a little bit of a good time, maybe be entertained, maybe follow along my journey, welcome. Welcome to another video. So I've been doing Q&As every Monday, Wednesday, Friday on Instagram. Follow me there, Silent Mike, M-I-K-K-E. Twitch streams every night, but on the Q&As, sometimes I'll get some interesting questions. We can do Q&As here. Obviously, we've done them in the past, and it seems like you guys enjoy it. But I like doing them on Instagram, and then a couple of them will stand out and turn into one of these bad boys. And so the overarching is programming for powerlifting. How do I learn how to program? Where do I start? Starting powerlifting is easy. You just begin. You can do a tiny bit of research, finding a program. There's tons of free programs, and I suggest finding a program, start lifting, build a routine, or find a coach, right? I don't mean to gatekeep here by any means. If you want to become a coach, if you want to become more knowledgeable, power to you. I'm here to help, and we'll talk about programming in this video. But for the majority of people, I don't know what the obsession is with learning how to program. I've been driving a car since I was 16. I think cars are cool. I like cars. I know a little bit about them. I am not a mechanic. When my car's busted or has issues, I call a friend that's a mechanic or I bring it to the shop. You don't have to know that much about powerlifting to be a powerlifter and to be very, very good, to enjoy it, to become healthier. You need the bare minimum. Learning how to program is literally like building an engine and building a custom engine. Because there's so many different parts and aspects that you can or cannot put into it. It's even more complicated than that because it's so vague and broad. An engine has to have certain parts. Programming kind of doesn't. That being said, if your thirst for knowledge is genuine, by all means, let's get after it. And I'll help you and comment below specific programming questions that I can help you with. But if you're just chasing this because it's like cool or you think you get popular off it or you think you maybe need to, you're overanalyzing it, don't. Stop. Grab a coach if you can afford it. Grab a program if you can't afford that much. There's tiers. Coaches cost the most. Programs like Kaizen Training give tons of information. I talk down millions of bullet points, instructional videos, plus the program itself. And below that, we even have free programs. Check that out. There's a lot of good coaches out there, the Joey Flexes, the Strength Athlete TSA, 3DMJ. Snag yourself a coach, get learn, and get better. But the obsession blows my mind. Now, that being said, when we're generally talking about programming, right, we're talking about, people are asking, how many times a week do I deadlift? How many times a week do I squat? We want to work with the minimum, and I talked about this in the last video a little bit, the minimum volume to get the most out of it. And then from there, all we're doing is progressively overloading. And that could be many things. It doesn't mean that we're adding 5 pounds to the bar every week, although for a true beginner in any sport, we probably can. That's what a lot of beginner programs have you do because your body adapts so quick. You're gaining the skill of lifting, building muscle, and the motor recruitment, the strength, so quickly that you can adapt training session, and add 5-10 pounds to squat, bench, and deadlift every single time. These things apply to conditioning. These things can apply, you know, drip down effect to sport and other things too, but lifting is kind of the X's and O's. So same with conditioning, right? If you want to run a marathon, you probably shouldn't just go run 10 miles every single day, every single week if you're out of shape. You want to run 1 mile every other day, and then the next week you might be able to run 1.2 miles every other day, and then the week after that you might be able to run 1 mile every single day or 5 days. And then after that you might be able to do 1.3, 1.5, right? And you build yourself up, and then we start to vary it once we get too fatigued. Once you get up to 5 miles a day, you might want to vary that. So the first day you're running 3 miles as quickly as you can. Then you're running a nice 5 miler. So the buildup and variance is basically just allowing us to manipulate the main factors, frequency, how often we do something. In powerlifting, it's easy, squat, bench, dead. In running, it's maybe a long run, a medium run, a light run. The volume, sets times reps times load. You could also throw into there how we progressively overload with time, meaning how much work do we do in a certain amount of time. So we can take shorter rest breaks, we can do EMOMs every minute on the minute. There's a lot of different ways to get better without just adding load, right? If I did three sets of five on bench and it took me 20 minutes and it's a lighter workout, now I can do three sets of five in 17 minutes and maybe I got better because of the stimulus. I'm training more volume, more work in less time under more fatigue, right? I don't necessarily recommend this for strength training, but that's something that can adapt to sport. It can adapt to your lighter days or your conditioning days or even your general fitness if you're doing accessories in powerlifting. But the main work, we wanna take longer breaks, right? We wanna get optimal focus, skill, and pushing into the bar as most powerful as we can during it. The last factor, we had frequency, we had volume, we had time, we can affect the time. So the main ones again are being time, frequency, and then the overall volume. And throughout a training program, then we adjust the exercises based on someone's needs to allow them to progress, whether they're injured, old, or their overall goals. People ask about the box squats too all the time. I don't think the box squat emulates a free squat well enough for a raw powerlifter, but if we're talking about a basketball player, if we're talking about a track athlete, if we're talking about maybe even a weightlifter, maybe we could sprinkle some of that in to get stronger in different positions, where in powerlifting, it's such a basic pattern that we have to drill into our souls to get really good at the squat. No, it's not that technical compared to some other things like a clean and jerk, etc., but it is still technical, and the more efficient we get at it, literally the more weight we can lift, the more weight, the more volume, the more frequency, the more we can recover from it, hence getting stronger over time. I know it was just a little bit of a rant in the beginning and just some very basic stuff about programming here that we covered, but there's a lot of beginner questions. So again, begin, ain't nothing to it but to do it. Start light, warm up, try to focus on some form, try to focus on a little bit more lifting, find a coach, find a program, find a free program. Those are the options. Do your own research to the extent that you can, but you don't have to be a mad scientist of strength and conditioning before you get better or to even be the best in the world. It's not necessary. You will learn over the time. It's a long journey. Build the program, build the routine, and start to get after it with your own goals. So I appreciate you for joining in. Again, follow me on Instagram. We're doing Q&As Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Twitch streaming every evening. And comment below specific programming questions. We're gonna tackle some programming, some beginner questions. I know it's kind of typical, the New Year's resolution stuff, but I wanna help you guys out with that. So begin your powerlifting journey now. I appreciate you. Take care of yourselves. Take care of your loved ones. Surround yourself with good company. Salam alaikum. I'm out.